is 0, the control input is 0 means what? High impedance state. Now, if the control input is 1, whatever you give at the input, that will come at the output side. If you give 0 as your input, 0 will be the output. If you give 1 as the input, you will get 1 as the output. This is the working of tri-state buffer. So mainly in case of tri-state buffer, you will have 3 input state and high impedance state or the control input. If the control input is 0, it acts like a high impedance state. So nothing will be transferred to the output. If the control input is 1, then whatever is given at the input, the same. Now use this tri-state buffer and a combination of tri-state buffer and a decoder is used for construction of a common bus system. The two ways of constructing the common bus system is, one way is using the multiplexers. We have already seen this. Just now, the second way is using the tri-state buffer. Decoder is multiplexer. In case of multiplexer, 2 power n inputs will be given, 1 output will come in a digital circuit which has n input lines and 2 power output lines. Multiple outputs will be there in the decoder, but in case of multiplexer, you will have a single output. You don't need much about this decoder as much, just see how this decoder will look like. So if the size of this decoder is 2 by 4, then you will have 2 input lines and 4 output lines. Now see the construction of this bus system using tri-state buffer, or you will say 3-state buffer. Just see this mark. You are using a combination of 3-state buffer and a decoder. This is one decoder and this is a tri-state buffer. So all this logic circuit will give one common bus line for transferring of a single bit. This complete thing will give a single line of your bus system. Assume that same we have 4 registers. A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D are the 4 registers we have. And you have a decoder which is of size 2 by 4. You will have 2 selection lines, S1 and S0. 4 outputs from 0 to 3. See here. This is the first tri-state buffer. To this first tri-state buffer, the 0th bit of the register A is given. Next to the second tri-state buffer, 0th bit of B, here 0th bit of C, and here 0th bit of D is given as input. Right? Now, tri-state buffer means what? It should have 3 states: input, this output, and a control input. And this control input will come from the output of the decoder. See, the control input of all this tri-state buffer will be the output of the decoder. So here we have a decoder of size 2 by 4. So it will generate 4 different outputs, and 4 outputs were given as a third state or as a control input to this tri-state buffer. Now see here, ma'am. One second. Now see here. So here, based on the selection lines, one will be chosen. Based on the selection lines, one will be chosen. Right. So here, if S1 and S0, if both the values are 0, 0, then what happened? The corresponding value is 0. So this 0 will become 1. This will become 1. When this value becomes 1, remaining all becomes 0, right? So it is 1 means what? To this tri-state buffer, the control input S1 and S0. If it is 0, the corresponding values of this port value will be 1. So this is 1 means what? Remaining will be 0. So this control input value is 0 means what? It acts like a high impedance state. So A0 will not be transferred on this common bus system. C0 will not be transferred. D0 will not be transferred. Only B0 will be placed on this line of common bus system. In the same way, if the combination is 1-0, this line will be chosen. This control input will be activated. So this will be activated. So C0 will be chosen. In the same way, if it is 1-1, then this will be activated. So in this way, based on these selection values, by using these tri-state buffers, you can construct the common bus system. Let us suppose if your register is having 4 bits, then you need to have these type of circuits. Four circuits you need to have. This complete thing is for what? 0th bit of the register. In the same way, you need to have A1 here, B1, C1 and D1. Again, choose 1 bit to place on the first line of the register. Next, you need to have one more A2, B2, C2 and D2. One more tri-state buffer, that output will be placed on bus line system, so that at the end one bus will be this using this tri-state buffer. I'm going to end my session today. I'll give 5 time. If you have any doubts in the chat box, I'll reply. How we can start the next session. If you want to me to revise, then revise for me know in the chat box. And whether the audio is clear or not today, let me know. What we have discussed today? Today we have discussed about the multiplexers, and in that we have discussed 2x1 multiplexer and 4x1 multiplexer and their logic circuits we have discussed. Next we have discussed the construction of the common bus system using the multiplexers. Using this multiplexer, how to construct the common bus system that we have discussed. Discussed a tri-state buffer. What is a tri-state buffer? How these tri-state buffer are constructing a common bus system. These are the things we have discussed today. After completion of the second part, this is the second part of your COA. When you see your JNTU syllabus, I am teaching the second part of your first unit. Once the second part is finished, I am going to share the PPTs as well as the complete notes to you. Whatever you feel comfortable, you can go through that. I am going to share the PPTs and the notes. You don't worry about the notes. Once the topics are finished, I'll send the notes. If you don't have any doubts, we can start the quiz. is the prescribed book for the COA is Morris Manobre topic syllabus. You can take that Morris Manobre book 7th edition. I'm not sure, just go through that syllabus. So in that you can have all these topics. Anyway, I'll send my notes. Everything will be there in my notes also. You go through the notes as well as the textbook and PPTs. I'm going to end my session for today. If you have any doubts, you just go through these topics and let me know in the next class. If time permits, I'll clarify your doubt. As of now, I'm closing and I'll start my quiz. And you'll be given 15 minutes of time to your quiz session. To answer, 15 minutes will be given for quiz session. Thank you.